from the 7th of May 2016. Champions League matches could be played at weekends from 2021. The idea is one of several being discussed by European governing body UEFA, who are actually going to vote in a new president in September. Just wanted to mention that. As it looks to maximise interest in its flagship club competition. Change to the Champions League schedule would not happen for at least 5 years because of broadcasting cycles. We are in constant dialogue with all stakeholders and any decisions will be taken in agreement with them, said a UEFA spokesman. It's far too early to speculate about changes to the formats of our club competitions. The Champions League, previously known as European Cup, has been played as a midweek competition since 1968. Its final was played midweek until 2010, but now that takes place on a Saturday. Weekend games could be staged at times more suited to the television audience in the Far East, but would require changes to domestic schedules.
The Champions League could be played on the weekends, which just hit me like a ton of bricks, because again, we're talking about fixture congestion and we're talking about the Champions League being played on a weekend, and we're talking about conflict of not just interest but conflict of competitions. You know, if Champions League is going to be played on the weekends, where, you know, most leagues are played on the weekends, you know, and if the top three teams of those leagues are playing on the weekends, and if they are in cup competitions that may be played on the weekends, and these competitions do have second legs and, you know, matches that are postponed, what happens when they clash with the Champions League matches? Now, I know the people of UEFA have probably, you know, thought about this, and on paper it sounds good. I'm just trying to work it out. Like, why complicate things when you've got a dedicated Wednesday and Tuesday to play the Champions League matches, and you get to play the final on a Saturday? Like, why? I don't understand why complicate the situation, because I can only see conflict and congestion, more congestion.
There's been a few interesting things said in the Skype chat, so we're gonna throw to that in a second. It is one of them ones where, yeah, we've had a couple of very interesting things said in the Skype chat. Jamie Bailey, did you want to jump in on these topics as well?
Champions League going to switching to Saturdays, bad idea. Unless you're going to change the leagues and say that they're playing from January to December, and then or January to maybe, I don't know, March, do what the MLS do, March to November, and then Champions League during the winter break.
That's a massive shake-up, though, and it wouldn't, and there would have to be a number of leagues that would have to change to actually accommodate that, though.
And that's like, it shouldn't happen. It's just pointless. It's the same thing with this whole Qatari movement again. Again, if you want to play the World Cup in a winter state, you should have done this probably 10 years ago, not now, so that we know what we're doing for now. Because now that the football's pretty much, it was a global sport before, but now that it's pretty much media based, everybody knows what they're doing. So all of a sudden you're going from, you know what, I know what I'm doing, to I can't help you anymore. I'm gonna, because all my stuff has changed. You're taking somebody's plan from what they're usually doing to now we're gonna have to change it fully, and then people are just gonna get confused for about a season or two. You don't need that confusion.
Champions League matches being played on weekends from 2021, terrible idea. I'm in agreement with Jamie. I think it was Jamie Bailey when he said that. I'm just one of them ones where I say, no, it's a terrible idea. That really is a terrible idea. You don't need to maximise interest in the Champions League. It's a case of the interest is already there. And one of the main reasons why I'm against it, not only just fixture congestion, but weekend games could be staged at times more suited to the television audience in the Far East, but would require changes to domestic schedules. That's the main reason I'm not a fan of that potential change, because what that would do, that would cause so much upheaval in domestic leagues, just for the sake of one quite small, in all honesty, region of the world. So, no, not in favour of that. Not in favour of that at all. The Football League with the one in a new 5-league, 100-club system is an interesting one. Ensuring more games are played on weekends and bank holidays. Well, you can kind of do that now if you get your scheduling right. So why do you need to add an extra division to facilitate that? That's what I don't get. Removing fixture congestion and clashes. If anything, you're going to get more fixture congestion because you're trying to accommodate another division. And if there's already fixture congestion with four divisions in the Football League, why would you add an extra one? Helping Football League clubs make more money. See, that can go kind of either way, because if you're creating an extra professional division, then two teams getting promoted from the Vanarama National League, and then the extra six teams would come up from the National League as well. What you've got to look at then is what if those teams are not ready, as Jamie Bailey said, to turn pro? What if those teams aren't ready financially, infrastructure, because there are stipulations that you have to have. Your ground has to be up to a certain level and all that. What if those other clubs are not ready? You're going to force them into something that they're not ready for, potentially. And that is dangerous. You could have clubs. You could have clubs getting promoted that are still semi-pro and are not ready to make that jump up to pro level, getting promoted just because they need to make up the numbers to make it up to 100 from 92. So I'm a little uncomfortable with it. Keeping the playoff finals on the last weekend of the domestic season. Well, that's down to scheduling. Again, this is just down to pure logistics and scheduling. So it's a case of, like, I'm just thinking of looking at it in that way, where it's a case of scheduling is where you need to look at. Ensuring more games are played on weekends and bank holidays, removing fixture congestion and clashes, and keeping the playoff finals on the last weekend of the domestic season. That's all scheduling and logistics.
Champions League when we're moving to a Saturday, I don't think that'll happen, to be honest. I like to watch it on the midweek day. So just for example, next season, Leicester's in the Champions League, so they're playing on a Saturday in Champions League, say, against Barcelona, and they're like going for a title as well towards the end of the season. What if they're like, they need to win the Premier League game, which is supposed to be on a Saturday, do you like change it to a midweek, which they don't want to? They're like a midweek congestion. But for me, I'd keep Champions League on midweek, so weekends for the football.